Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time for Random Run Day here, the Binding of Isaac Victa Repentance series. And yes, we did finally get a video going over 5,000 likes. Only took like a week and a half or so or something like that. So I'm not really sure if we can consider it a like streak anymore. I think it got broken a while ago. But with the ongoing YouTube issues, blah, 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 we're gonna keep the course right now until we figure out what's going on. And thank you all very much for those of you who have been continuing to support throughout this entire week and a half of craziness. I really appreciate it. I'm looking forward to seeing who we got today. I don't know. You don't know because the thumbnail doesn't spoil it. But first off, here's your meme of the day. This one brought to you by Raz123. Title of the thread was Daily Meme Attempt Part 5. Normally, I wouldn't even give a meme of the day to this one, but this one had a lot of upvotes, and you know, we got to recognize effort. So thank you very much, Raz123, the average Devil Deal fan or the average Angel Deal enjoyer. Giga Chad versus the, I don't know what the other one is. So thank you very much, Raz. All right, here we go. The randomizer is ready to go. It's a non-tainted run. So it's just regular old something. What do we got? Again, shout out to TRPGstuff.com giving us this randomizer. Everything has been enabled for characters and bosses, and none of the custom challenges have been enabled. So today we are going to be... All right, well, at least we're just going to Blue Baby, but yeesh. All right, well, it's been a long time since I played as the Lost, and here we go. Here we go. All right, hold on to your butts. CJ's going to be Hotel 7, X-Ray, Golf 1, Lima, Foxtrot 8. So, playing as the Lost. You know, there's good and bad, right? Like, the good is that you got Holy Mantle as the regular Lost. This isn't Tainted Lost, so obviously it's just a much better character. Starscar, the reverse Starscar, I don't think does anything for us right now, does it? Removes the oldest, yeah, I don't think it does anything. But we can use it inside of the secret room, and that might be able to do something. We get Telepathy for Dummies, and we also start with the Eternal D-Sizzle, which did that. All right. The Eternal D6 has a chance to reroll an item, or it will consume the item pedestal. And of course, the Lost can only has zero. If you're wondering where the HP is, it's not because of Curse of the Unknown or anything like that, but the Lost has zero HP, period. So once you get hit once, you are dead. You're D-E-A-D dead. So, but thankfully, we have the Holy Mantida, which is a big part and what keeps the Lost alive, and also a big part of what makes the Lost an awesome character, as it does allow us to, you know, not get completely insta-gibbed by, like, you know, some Isaac BS, like, you know, I don't know, starting in a room that has a bunch of barrels in it with a troll bomb. I don't know. Oh, that was an instant fire there by the burning Claudie. Another nice thing about the Lost is that you can take Devil Deals, but you can only take one of them. So you can take Devil Deals for free, but it's going to cost you, you have to choose wisely, in other words. And again, it is fortunate that we are only going to Blue Baby here. And I'm fine with that. Super duper fine with that. It could have been a lot scarier, that's for sure. I wouldn't mind getting Humbling Bun to do. So I don't remember if it's the Lost that has 9 lives and all that stuff, if that's all disabled, or if it's just the Tainted Lost. All that stuff is like patch note stuff, and I don't pay attention to those. I know I should, but I never keep up with them anymore, man. Like, we've had so many. Okay, so I don't know if the Stars card will remove the Eternal D-Sizzle or just not do anything. I think it's not going to do anything. I was right. It just didn't do anything. Had I actually had an item, though, it would have given us, assumably, something inside of the secret room. So that's good to know. Good to remember. Yeah, if you don't have a starting passive item, then it just doesn't do anything. It doesn't give you a free item. So it's good to know. Now we know. Obviously, soul hearts don't really matter. What you really want for the Lost is you want overwhelming damage. And obviously, any type of transformation, any type of extra life. Guppy's Collar, you know, anything that can bring you back from the brink is what you want. What you don't want is orbitals. Orbitals are a big no bueno for us. No Magusta orbitals here. So, but this is where the Eternal D6 comes into play, because obviously we can at least re-roll cube of meat or ball of bandages, depending on what we get here from Blue Famine. A little bit slap in the face that we get Blue Famine anyway, because not only does it give us an item that we don't want, but it also gives us a soul heart that we cannot profit from at all. So in other words, what I'm trying to say is that getting Famine as our first boss, a Blue Famine at that, could not have been more useless as the loss. Unless if you're like, you're just a madman or a madwoman who just plays with orbitals on the Lost, then hey, more power to you. Hey. Super stoked that everybody was pretty happy to see a little bit of a different type of video yesterday. I know that it was a departure from our daily run-of-the-mill videos, but I had taken it easy yesterday. I really strained my voice from the Isaac Madness streams, and I wanted to it was nice to not have to record for a day and just use what I recorded on stream for YouTube. So and I'm glad that everyone enjoyed it. Those kind of videos, you can expect if those kind of videos do well on the channel, which that one has already done very well, just because it's something different, though that kind of stuff, you can definitely expect more of. The more support it gets on YouTube, the more apt I am to do more of those. And they're just a lot of fun, period. We have a lot of fun with the daily runs and stuff. Switching up the characters has certainly helped out a whole lot. Yes. Switching out the characters, random run days, that kind of stuff. I'm intertwining more variation and that sort of thing, more fun stuff into the Isaac series. Is definitely the next evolution of the series on the whole, in my opinion. And doing stuff with Daruls is a lot of fun. I mean, those of you who've tuned into the Isaac Madness streams on Twitch, you'll know that they're bonkers. They are cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs. I guess I'll take Adrenaline. It doesn't do anything for us, but at least gives us one of three for Spun, and who knows. The Lost is all about capitalizing on big damage. You want big, big damage. And, going from Ball of Bandages to Meat, it gives us damage. It doesn't give us big damage, but it gives us damage, and that's more than what we can say for, like, an Orbital. Nun's Habit's literally worthless. And now literally gone. All right. Nun's Habit only triggers off of damage, and since we are the Lost, we cannot take damage. But yeah, I mean, thank you again for those of you who supported that video. And if you want to see more of that kind of stuff, then definitely leave comments, drop likes, all that kind of good stuff. Despite what YouTube is whatever the heck is going on with YouTube right now, the Mosh Pit's still coming out in droves to support, and I really appreciate that. You gotta be really careful here. Not a fan of champion gurglings, especially yellow ones, especially when we get one more than we're supposed to. Obviously, with the speed that they charge at, you gotta be real careful when you shoot them, as they tend to fly off the handle. There we go. HP, we'll go ahead and wait for a reroll there. And we get Aya Guppy. Or Abba Dabba Ding Dong. I mean, we can take Aya Guppy for a Guppy item. Reroll the HP, and we got a Tears Up. You know what? It could have been a lot worse. I will take that for sure. And I think that we can bomb our way into the Dice Room, I believe, in a thing called Love. Just listen to the rhythm of my heart. Okay. Definitely getting a lot of money from the store is also pretty important. This is a global D20, and that actually might be pretty good. I am going to take the key because we kind of need it. We'll take that. Maybe we can reroll something. Get an extra bomb out of this. We get extra nothing out of that. We do get a golden chest, though. And that's going to turn into a bomb. Not the greatest. But there is one more Yave in the boss room. And actually, we can get not only a quarter, but we can get another key here, too. Basically, trade a bomb for a key, and that's really nice. This also allows us to try to get the super secret room, which is here. And that gave us a whole lot of nothing. We'll take it. So, not a great devil deal, admittedly. Not the most impactful one, but hey, we got a devil deal guppy item. And Curse of the Blind. Womp, 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 womp. So unfortunately, I don't think Guppy's Eye shows you the blind item in the chest, or it might. Man, Curse of the Blind has really been a thorn in our side lately. I don't know why. Like, I need someone give us the last 2 weeks of floor 3 Curse of the Blinds. I would love to see what the count is over the last 14 days. Let me know in the comments, and I'll pin it, assuming that I see it. Obviously, as a loss, we can take advantage of our spectral tiers. We don't have to stand in front of enemies, assuming that they're not hosts. We can shoot over rocks, that sort of stuff, so we can stay relatively safe. It's not total immunity, but, you know, it helps out a lot. And of course, having flying is also pretty pogged. It's like, you know, do you go blind items on the lost? No. No, you really don't. Gonna focus on one greed head at a time if possible. That was the laziest little double leap I think I've ever seen from a greed head. Pretty sure he clipped into those rocks. We'll go into the store because it might be a greed fight. 40 cents. I'm going to stick with the Eternal D-Sizzle. Oh, God. We got Broken Modem. Poke-Go. And Bob's Curse. Okay. Figured the shop was so bad, it can't get any worse. So I'm not a huge fan of Broken Modem. I know that some people really like it. I don't. Yes, it does remove some projectiles from enemies. And actually, ironically, on the Lost, it could be a pretty powerful item if we had to do if we had to fight like Mom's Heart, which of course we're going to have to because we got to go to Blue Baby. Yeah, see that's the thing that I don't like. Even though it removes the projectile, I could inadvertently try to dodge one way and end up not having to go there, and then put myself in an awkward position to not make a dodge that I really need to something that doesn't lag. So it's anything. For me, I mean, those of you who've watched me long enough, you know my tendencies by now. You know that anything that kind of modifies the game in a way that messes with, like, the shot speed or the way that enemies move, or, you know, anything that is predictable that becomes unpredictable due to an item, I'm usually not going to be happy about. And that's just, I mean, that just comes from my conservative gameplay style, and, you know, I want to minimize the amount of risk as much as possible. Very interesting game. My screen, that looked like it was going to hit him, but apparently not. There we go. Perfection, which is much better for the lost, and HP, which is not. Curse of Lost. Cat of Nine Tails is real good. can't pass up Cat of Nine Tails. We're just going to have to fight Rag Mega again. It's a dangerous fight for the lost. As Bighorn. Rag Mega and Bighorn. That is a horrible... That is a god-awful draw for fighting as the lost. No Magoose to this. Yeah, there's no way I turned down Cat of Nine Tails. Get the poison on him. Bob's Curse, actually a pretty big pickup for us. Okay, so we got out of there unscathed, thankfully. Perfection is going to give us a 10 luck rating as long as we don't take any damage. And, of course, since we're playing as a lost, you take damage, you die. That's just how it goes. There's a Charge Beggar in there, so we can destroy him for a little bit of extra... a little bit of extra Devil Deal chance for this floor. I'm going to hold off on that in case we need the full charge for our Eternal D-Sizzle. See, it's another thing is that, like, I don't know if the projectiles that get suspended in midair by, Fatty Batty was blocking that chest. Or I was. One of the two. I'm going to blame Fatty Batty. Yeah, so I don't know if the projectiles that are stopped by, modem lag, I don't know if they're actually, like, collidable or not. Seeing why Pokego is not a very good item here, because the enemies that get charmed by Pokego, they don't always shoot at the enemies. The actual enemies, they will shoot at Isaac, and that's a big problem. I have a bedroom. Normally I'd be pretty pogged about this, but since we're playing as a loss, we don't really have Soul Heart, so it doesn't really matter. I don't think this is really worth the two bombs, but if there is a clean room, which there's not, had there been a clean room, it would have been fine. We could also just skip this entire floor, but I don't think that would be wise, considering that we're pretty much guaranteed to get a Devil Deal here. Oh no, Fat Bat, oh no, how could this happen to him? He made a mistake. We go on. Secret room should be to the left of here, should be. Shout out to the Eternal D-Sizzle for at least giving us some kind of hope. Some kind of re-roll ability here. 5 cents guaranteed from this keeper. And we found our shop. Which is undoubtedly going to have a greed fight in it. No, it's Hive Mind, actually. Ooh, man. Now, Coupon is very interesting. The reason why Coupon is interesting is because it gives us the ability to take multiple Devil Deals instead of just one as the lost. So I think under those circumstances, I think you gotta go with Coupon, right? I mean, you gotta go with Coupon here. I don't like the Eternal D6, I'm gonna be completely honest, even though I just gave it a shout out. I don't like the Eternal D6 because I think that losing an item is kind of BS when all you're trying to do is just simply reroll a bad item. So yeah, I'm all for the Coupon here, as this will give us a very good opportunity to get a free Devil Deal without us having to incur the penalty of us actually being the lost, which is going to limit us in taking one and only one Devil Deal items. I don't remember where's that charge beggar? Yeah, we give him 5 cents. We're not going to get an extra charge out of that. So we get a pretty much guaranteed devil deal. I say pretty much because we all know Sinvicta Luck exists. But a 90% devil deal chance, surely, right? Surely we can't possibly fail this. Right? Right? We'll be, I mean, yeah, it's, I mean, come on now. It's 90%. Like, what kind of unlucky moron fails a 90% RNG roll? Super Secret Room might be here. It is. All right, Eternal Heart. It's going to be very useful for us playing as the Lost. I really want this charmed one bat or one tooth to die. Give me Big Horn. One tooth, you alright? Freeze there by modem lag. Got him right as the bomb poison was going off. I don't think we need to use our last bomb here. Wow, that momentum did not stop at all for that bomb. Another HP upgrade. All right. Well, we still have the eternal D6 that we can at least re-roll the devil deal, because we have that full charge that's on the ground in that one room. We got to go all the way back for it, though. There's another full charge here as well. So obviously here we're going to be wanting to reroll the devil deal item, assuming the door is open. It's not. And we get booster back, which could be good. Sun card we'll definitely hold on to. Actually. The 4chan card. Okay. Queen of Hearts. You thought I was going to lose perfection, didn't you? You thought poor old Sinvicta was just going to herp derp it and just forget about perfection. You thought I was going to turn into bombs, didn't you? No faith, man. No faith. All right, so I still think that the coupon is the right play. Again, aforementioned, I don't like overly dig the Eternal D6. It is nice to have a reroll, but losing the Atom Pedestal can be devastating. So yeah, and I mean we got a lot of bombs and we got a Sun card, so that's, you know, that's something, right? All right, Necropolis 1. Skirt. Oh, baby. 9 lives, our second Guppy item. Now we're talking. All right. So 9 lives does show up for the Lost. Confirmed, obviously. And Modem Lag just said hoof to all the shots from Greed. No danger for you. Steam sale would have been nice, but that's okay. So we get a little bit of wiggle room. Let's go to the shop first, since we're here. Yeah. Car battery is quite bueno. Car battery is going to allow us to use the coupon twice. And battery baby, I mean, yeah, charge baby's pretty good. So we can go get, we're guaranteed to get battery baby. Well, let's go to the item room first so we don't have to come back here. We waste one full, we waste one charge, but we got a Vis here. This is, the Vis's are great for Pokego. We get a full charge there, so now we're gonna have to come back ironically anyway. Yeah, I mean, I'll tell, like, we're not going to use Notched Axe, but we definitely will utilize Mom's Purse for double trinket, especially since we have Perfection. Our trinket slot's basically dead right now, so I'm all for that. Don't you walk into the spikes of the fire. Don't you do it. Okay. I wouldn't be mad. I'd be very just disappointed in you. Okay. Movement speed up, definitely a welcome one, but we are going to have to get a full charge before we go have a chance to go fight our deal with the devil. Obviously, because we want to have, well, the whole point of us taking the coupon was so we would have it for the deal with the devil. I don't know how he's still alive, man. Big time plays, Vis. Big time plays. Come on, Vis. Light up, Chubb. Light her up. Light her up. Yeah! There we go. That's what I like to see, son. That's what I'm talking about. The Eternal Fly took out the rest, but we will have enough. We will barely have enough for a full charge for the Devil Deal. Yeah, the Vis mobs. If you somehow are able to summon a Vis mob, man, you are laughing. You are all kinds of happy. I don't know why we went through this way. Just gonna pretend it was deliberate. Luck plenty as well. 12 luck is nothing to sneeze at. Oh, good. Oh, baby. You love to see it. Wow. That was the most owning piece of ownage I've ever seen happen to Bloat. Good lord. And we get Bookworm as well. Oh, man. Vis, I love you. If that part right there didn't get your like, I don't know what will. Get Abba Dabba Ding Dong, which, I mean, we might as well just take because it doesn't matter. And Abaddon is going to be a fantastic damage and movement speed upgrade for us. And as you can see, it doesn't affect the loss because, again, we have no HP. No big deal. This Vis is doing work. Sign this Vis up for the Buccaneers or something, man, because it is owning things. We lost Tom. We need a new big time player here. Get a Planetarium. Could potentially be pretty pogged. Tower card, not really going to interest me a whole lot. We get Mercurius as well. Oh, man. Well. I'm a fan. Mercurius is going to give us a movement speed upgrade, but more importantly, allows us just to run right through the level and the doors. Can't get away from a super greed fight, though. There we go. Blood Bomb's doing a number on super greed. Super greedy. We can just simply nope on out of rooms that not only do we not want to be in, but we can also just, we can get a whole bunch of summons from a Pokego. Uh-oh. No! I didn't think it was going to actually kill it. Well, that this was an absolute monster, an absolute legend. Hopefully we get another one. I will say that the mom fight on the Lost, even regular Lost, is not a gimme. Unless you've got overwhelming damage or you've got a overwhelming this. And you can see our damage is pretty decent. Our tears rate is also pretty decent. We're not dealing a lot of damage. Like, I would like to see our damage be a little bit better. I'd love to get a tear effect. Anything like that would be very beneficial. Very close. Watching the door, not watching the shadow. There we go. No deal with the devil. It doesn't matter because we already knew it was Abaddon in there. We're going to head on down. Let's get some mapping. Also, I should mention that some people were saying that the audio levels were a little bit screwy in a couple of the more recent episodes. It's because I was mostly leaning back in my chair, and I'm trying not to do that, so I apologize. You would think that I wouldn't do that after a while, but I did adjust my mic settings like last week, so having the noise gate on a different setting is it's a little bit different. Not used to it being so touchy. Moon card. Might as well go to the moon card. The moon. It's not like we can't just run right back to the boss room. Judgment. We can play the judgment. Probably not going to get us much of anything here. I mean, again, mapping would be cool. I'm not going to turn that down. Not mapping, that is mom's bottle of pills. I got the poison blood bomb on him. Not that he's affected by the blood bomb creep, because obviously he's in the air, but so we dealt a decent amount of damage. Hey, look at that. We poisoned the pale horse. And we'll take the cube meat and head on this down. Speeding up here. All right. So again, without mapping, we have absolutely no clue where we're supposed to be going. So we're just going to kind of wing it, and in typical Invicta fashion, we start off in the wrong direction. It's not even like we need these full charges or anything, right? So it doesn't really hurt us to skip all these rooms. You know, making it to mom's heart, or it lives in a really quick time here. Again, this is also not a not a gimme boss as the Lost. You can get some difficulty here. My goal is to not lose a life from 9 lives, though. If possible. So here's where... This is a situation where having modem lag is actually a good thing, because it does tend to remove a lot of the projectiles. But even if it removes them, always dodge like you're like they're coming after you no matter what. I accidentally shot that one away. That wasn't my fault. Okay, stop firing. How about that? Stop firing. How about that? There we go. No deal with the devil. 34%, and that is okay. Still on a roll, man. I am just slightly peeved that we didn't get Guppy, because we have Hive Mind and we've had 2 or 3 Guppy for a while now. That and our first item was, you know, Guppy's eye. So it would have been nice to have completed the set. Those of you who are in card collecting circles out there, but it is what it is. No master set for us. And this is where, I didn't mean to do that, but this is where Mercurius really helps out. And we get a moon car, a reverse moon car, which is going to give us the ultra secret room. Blank rune. No thanks. I was looking for the looking for small rock, it would have been nice. Blank rune could give us alges. Oh. Gives black rune, and that's the precise reason why I decided to not use it in that room, as I've had multiple things on the ground pretty much destroyed by the random black rune from blank rune. Which, in my opinion, I don't think a black rune should be a possibility from blank rune, because it makes it way, way worse just to take blindly. Like, you, if you're, imagine expecting like a Perthro rune and then you get stuck with like a black rune. Like, that's not what I want for my runes. You have to ask yourself, is this item pedestal worth losing? Really want to try to stop the fetuses from spawning before they get to the third wave here. Good bomb there. Again, the creep is not dealing damage here. It's the poison gas from Bob's Curse. This is an excellent weapon to use against Isaac. And I moved too fast. Yeah. That momentum, man. That momentum is a killer. So what happened there is that we moved a little bit too fast, too close to Isaac, and Isaac kind of slid. Well, the Lost kind of slid into Isaac. And that's why I really don't like you. That's the reason why I really don't like having 2.0 movement speed. Anything above 1.75 is too fast. For that, oh, I didn't even see that shot. For that precise reason. There we go. Get the blood bomb creep going on Isaac. I'm gonna keep dodging as if we don't have modem lag. It's unfortunate that we lost perfection, but what can you do? That's that pattern right there is definitely the hardest pattern to dodge. Some crazy shot speed there, Isaac. All right, we lost a couple of lives. I'm not too happy about that, but we're past Isaac. And we're really not doing this. Well, Deadeye's great. Scorpio's also great, but man. We're really not doing this with fantastic damage either. This right here, this is the good stuff with Mercurius, yeah. That right there is the bee's knees, I tell you what. Being able to skip the entire chest as, I mean, that's almost like having an Emperor card, almost. As the Lost is just beautiful. Deadeye's gonna give us a stacking damage buff. So the more consecutive shots we hit on targets, the higher it stacks and the more damage we deal. That should be GG. Should be. Never know with Blue Baby. You're doing great, Leech. Keep it up. Doing phenomenal. There we go. Like missing like a 3-foot putt and then making like a 15-footer. So we are gonna get the dub here. Thank you for watching, everyone. Again, thanks for getting the video over 5,000 likes. It's been a little bit, and hopefully this trend starts to get back to normal here as hopefully YouTube's figuring out what the heck's going on. But another random run day in the books. We got the Lost, and we went straight to Blue Baby. And you know, it was a pretty good run. So try out that seed for yourself. Let me know what changes you would have done down in the comments. I really appreciate those of you who do play through these seeds and let me know with the updates and how everything kind of deviated and whatnot. And thank you for the support on yesterday's video as well. I really appreciate it. So we're going to have two rounds, by the way. Those of you who are patrons wondering about the Patreon shout out, they're going to have two rounds. So the following list at the end credits here is going to be from yesterday's video and today's video. So thank you again for letting me take the day off yesterday. I really appreciate it. Have a great start to your Sunday, and as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Drew Couch, Brader Rowe, Daniel Horowitz, Charleston, Joe Sandor, Jade Fright, Min Win, Bart Mayuswin, Thibet Heagle, Rake409, Ben Ramsey, and Cody the Wolf. Thank you for very much for supporting me on Patreon. You can go to patreon.com/sinvicta for all of your shout-out needs.